In this lesson, we will be implementing the reset method of the custom gym environment for the inventory management problem. In the previous video, we have defined the init method where we define the allowed ranges for some of the problem parameters. For example, lambda or the daily mean demand had bounds from 0 to 200. The selling price per unit had a range from 0 to 100. And the holding cost per unit per day had a range from 0 to 5. But note that while these are variables that can take values across a range, for a particular shop, the values of daily mean demand, unit selling price, daily holding cost per unit, so these three, is constant. So for example, if you have a banana shop, you might have a lambda of 50. The unit selling price might be $5. And let's say an unit is a dozen bananas or something like that. The unit buying price might be 2 and the daily holding cost per unit might be 0.5. However, if you're dealing with a wine shop, the parameters might be different. So the mean demand might be 30. Wine is more expensive than banana, so the unit selling price might be 15. The unit buying price might be 7. The daily holding cost per unit might be a little less because wine is less perishable than bananas. And in general, different shops will have different but fixed parameters. So in our environment, each episode should simulate a different shop with different parameters. So, and these parameters should stay constant during an episode. For example, in episode number 1, these could be the parameter values. In episode number 2, these could be the parameter values, and so on. The idea is that the agent should see in each episode a different shop with different parameters. And if we train an agent in such an environment, then we will train a policy that can work in a wide variety of shops with different parameters. This is the reason why we included these parameters in the environment state, because each episode will have different values of these parameters, and the agent needs to know what the current parameter values are. So the reset method needs to initialize such an episode, which means to fix the problem parameters. And that can be done by sampling from the parameter space. So we'll sample from this space, sample from this space, sample from this space. And that would give us a particular shop with particular parameters. And then we can run an episode of 3 months or 90 days on that particular shop when these values are held fixed. Okay, so with that introduction, let's try to implement the reset method. So as I said, the principal value, the principal job of the reset method now is to sample the parameter values from the parameter space. And for that, we would need some kind of a random number generator. So we first import the default random number generator from numpy.random. And then, since we will be using this random number generator throughout the environment, the best place to define that is as an instance variable called self.rng. And then just use the default random number generator of NumPy. And then we can use this random number generator to access various probability distributions in the reset method. So let's start sampling the problem parameters, and starting with the mean daily demand. So the mean daily demand can be anything from 0 to 200, which is the max mean daily demand. So what we will do is that we will first sample from an uniform distribution from 0 to 1, and then just multiply the sample with self.max mean daily demand, and that will give us a value between 0 and self.max mean daily demand. Then we set the selling price. We use the same principle to generate that sample. Then we set the buying price. But note that the buying price cannot be higher than the selling price because we are assuming that we always sell products for a profit. So the buying price is a sample from the uniform distribution from 0 to 1, and then we multiply by the previously sampled selling price to cap the buying price with the selling price. Now let's set the daily holding cost per unit. Same principle applies. But note that the holding cost cannot be higher than the buying price, because I'm assuming that if a product completely perishes, then we lose nothing more than the original price that we spent to acquire that product. So therefore, I will multiply by the minimum of the buying price and self.max daily holding cost per unit. All right, so that fixes the four main problem parameters. And therefore, we can now return the first observation, which is the primary job of the reset method. So I define an instance variable called self.currentObs, which will always store the current observation. And since I like to define all the instance variables in the init method, I will just set self.currentObs equal to none over here. This is not really required. Python allows you to define instance variables inside other methods as well, but I find this to be a good way of keeping track of which instance variables this instance of the class might have. All right. So what should be the first observation? So the state has two parts, as we said as we saw in the last video. The first five elements are the on-hand inventory and the historical actions. And since we are initializing the environment now, we are in day number zero, we will assume that we have no on-hand inventory, so zero on-hand inventory. And the concept of historical actions does not even apply right now because there are no historical actions on day number zero. So we will set all of these values to zero. So starting with an array filled with zeros and of size self.lead time. That would cover the on-hand inventory and the historical actions. And then comes the next part where we set the values of the daily demand, selling price, etc. to the sample we just chose. And then reset should also return the initial state. So we return self.currentOps. All right, so that's how you define the reset method of a custom gym environment. And the idea, the main idea, is very simple. You need to just return the initial state of the episode, of an episode. And if you want to randomly vary some of the observation elements of the initial state, so do random initializations, then you need to sample the observation, those observation elements that you want to randomize from their respective bounds. It is in general a good idea to randomize the initial state because that leads to more robust agent policies. If you remember, Cartpool V1 also has some randomization during its initialization. So if you set up the Cartpool V1 environment and repeatedly run reset, you will see that different initial states are returned. All right, so that's it for the reset function. And in the next video, we are going to implement the step method in the inventory management custom environment.